If you look at the way the movement has been able to engage with authorities and influence decision making, and also structure forums for interactive engagement in terms of participation, I think it's influenced the thinking of authorities. If you look at a classical example of the city of Nairobi, today, Muungano as a movement has space. It's got some sort of like virtual office space within the urban administration, and they can occupy that at their will. They will go in and make decisions, and they will be implemented. Again, if you look at other places, like the rolling out of programs like Kissing and the rest, they acknowledge Muungano as a major force in that. So in my view, then the movement has influenced how things are done at a broader scale as well. And I can only imagine that things will get better for Muungano. There are links between Muungano actions and actual changes.
Yes.
Like we've just discussed before, the whole issue of the housing agenda. You see, they've had an agitation for housing, and there are deliverables on the ground that they've already gotten in terms of, you know, real housing. Now, if you look at the agitation from Muungano for empowerment, you know, and recognition in decision-making forums, that they've achieved. And we've just discussed that, how they've opened up that space, and they can now claim it in decision-making forums. Now, if, again, you look at just agitation for security of tenure, that in itself has been achieved in many quarters. So it's possible to see these links between actions, I mean, and what has been realized on the ground.